Okay, folks, just making a real quick video here to show you what we have working. This is your standard RAMPS RepRap controller. What I've done here is removed the Polulu drivers on this side, taken those guys out, put in a set of pin headers and made up a little connector here with a cable running to this guy, which is the THB6064AH driver. We're selling the kit for this, which includes the boards and the parts and the chip. These drivers are really, really fantastic little units. It is a Toshiba-made product, and it will do 50 volts and 4.5 amps continuous. It is not something that is a peak rating, so it's a very good little unit. And we've got that hooked up to a nice big honking NEMA23 motor here. And over on the screen, you may be able to see there in the corner, prompter face is running, or printer face, printer interface, and we are stepping. Now, in the CNC world, nobody would really care about that. Not a big deal. You see things like that every day. What's unusual here is that this unit is running the Merlin firmware, standard, off the shelf, everybody's running, or that a lot of people are running. And it puts out a step pulse, which is 1.88 milliseconds, excuse me, microseconds, that's US, microseconds long. Very, very, very narrow step pulse. Most stepper motor controller systems will not, the drivers will not actually handle that. So I had tried previously with a lovely little open source Linestepper driver, which would be a great fit for the RepRap community since it's open source. Just is used as a pick that you can program. They're commonly available, pretty cheap. You can build your own boards or probably even build a different shield that would accommodate the driver right into it. The problem is that it's running code within the pick that is polling or waiting for that signal to come in. And the signal is so short that the pick doesn't have time to see it. And so we miss steps and you get this, you know, really horrible run when you try to actually get it to spin the motor. It just, you know, goes crazy. So these Polulu drivers, the chip that they use from Allegro is actually rated at being able to accept a 1 microsecond pulse, which is, again, very unusual. Most of the drivers in the CNC world, most of these big guys like this one, they just cannot handle that kind of tiny little pulse. This particular chip, according to the manufacturer's data sheet, is actually rated as needing a minimum 2.3 microsecond pulse for the step pulse. However, as you can see, it is working perfectly, even under load. And this really is kind of the point here. You know, why do you care about this? Why are we looking at this even? Well, here's why. I'm holding on to this pretty much as hard as I can. Ow! Okay, that hurts. So these are extremely strong motors, and they can actually move quite quickly. So I'm pretty happy with this. I think this is something that we might be able to make use of. This is, you know, potentially useful for people who are working with very large units, very large RepRap machines, trying to expand the size of it. And that, by the way, is 5,000 millimeters per minute on the prompter face interface. So screaming right along. Okay, just wanted to show you that. Again, it is exceeding manufacturer specifications on the data sheet, but this is one of the few drivers I've found that is capable of handling those tiny little steps. We are going to investigate the possibility of building a little pulse stretcher, which will take that tiny 1 microsecond pulse and stretch it out so that it could potentially be used with the Linestepper, but that is for another day. Thanks, bye-bye.